It is always nice to have you. If this is the first time you are getting to watch my videos, thank you very much. During the pandemic, millions and millions of people lost their jobs. I don't know who you are, I don't know what you do, but you may be affected in one way or the other. We all need to create something from the beginning and make sure that we don't wake up thinking about who will fire us. So today I'm going to talk about 10 business ideas that you can start now, or you can project that in the near future. My name is Ibrahim Mustafa, and I believe in you, and I believe we can learn something today. But before we start, I tell you those business ideas. Let's go to point number one. If you are the type who contemplates, if you are the type who procrastinates, if you are the type who your mindset always keeps telling you that you cannot do it, it's not enough, it's not possible, you don't have the capital, you don't have anyone to support you, you don't have the support, you're not educated enough, you don't have the degree, please, if you're that type of person, this video is not for you, because eventually you will talk your way out of this business, those businesses. But if you are someone who believes that it's possible, you can do it. You don't have the resources now, but you can gather the resources. If you are persistent, you can make a difference. If you are that type of person, then let's go straight to business idea number one, because you are meant to be. With the right marketing, dedication, mindset, you can win in any business. So business number one is real estate business. A lot of people are homeless, not because it's a choice. A lot of people don't even have the luxury to build their own apartments or homes. It's a waste of time and all those things. You can venture into real estate and create that demand. Create a niche for yourself and give people the opportunity to buy homes, or you can build. You can even do land banking, whereby you buy plots of land at areas that are underdeveloped now and you sell them in the near future. You can also help people get accommodation. You can even start Airbnb or even short stay. It's all possible. Real estate industry is huge. And once you learn into it, you can get to know specifically what you want to do. Then, number two, you can start a poultry farm. 80% of the world, I believe, this is just my pure research, my personal research, consume chicken. Fried rice without chicken or rice without chicken, something that's. So a lot of people buy chicken or egg and they use that. So if you venture into poultry farming, the market is there, the demand is there, you will get to sell and you will get to make an impact. You can also reverse engineer by getting into buying or producing chicken feed so that you can feed people who are into the poultry farm. Give them the opportunity to feed their poultry. So this sector is also huge. You can venture into it, learn into it, and see. You can even organize training programs for people to know if you are into the poultry farm or you know how it is done. You can organize trainings, short courses, master classes, and people will attend for you to get more money from that. Number three is carrier or delivery services. People want to receive products, goods, or services, whatever it is, at the shortest possible time. So in your community, and during the pandemic, we saw that delivery services rose to the highest because people were home and only delivery services were even allowed at a point to do deliveries because people still need to eat, they still need to buy gifts for their loved ones, they still need to get packages, parcels, deliveries, letters, employment contracts and all those things. And delivery services are the people who can make that possible. So if you start a courier or delivery service, maybe you have a motorbike, scooter, or a car that is of low consumption, you can start with that. If you are the type that you can also personally even take public transport to deliver service products, that's good, you can start. You can also leverage on other people who have delivery services, and you can use that to start your own delivery service. So this is also a business that you can go into. Number four is restaurant. People don't cook these days. Personally, I don't see it. They need to waste time 4 hours, 5 hours in the kitchen and you have to do dishes, clean, or no. I just prefer to get to a place and buy my food within some specific short time. I get it done and I'm okay, go back to work and stuff. Because people are stressed for them to be wasting a lot of time to go to the market, come back, cook, get gas, a lot of stuff. So restaurant is becoming something that people easily, or what, at work or before work, they just get, or even after work, they just get into and they eat. So if you start a restaurant business, it's also lucrative because the profits are high and the margins are high. Then the fifth business that you can start is spices business. So if you are from maybe where I'm coming from, which is Ghana, Africa, there are a lot of spices, from pepper, from ginger. So you can package, grind them, package them well, in their raw states, and you start selling. So you can see this. I have a well-packaged ginger powder, dry powder, and that's someone's business. So you can start it and sell online on Etsy. You can sell on Amazon if you do all the right registrations, FDA registration and stuff. You can start selling in your local community. You can start selling spices, so for people to buy, and it's lucrative at malls, supermarket shops. You can display them for people to get to see your brand and buy from you. Number six is beauty products. A lot of beauty products. You see that women or men want to look good. They want simple off-the-shelf products that will give their skin natural feeling, good looks, and once they get that, they will venture to buy those things. So you can start a beauty product line whereby you can even do retail or wholesale of beauty products. You can also start your own beauty products line whereby you shea butter or almond, whatever it is, to create your own beauty products. And it's simple to create and you can do that. You can also leverage on other people's products to sell, to distribute, and to reach out to what, a wider market. So this is a seed business you can start with. The seventh business is daycare or basic school. A lot of people will love to give their children the best education. So if you have a daycare that can cater for the needs of these kids, so that their parents can go to work and come back and meet them happy, then you have a business. So you can establish a basic school whereby you give these children this opportunity, and people will come and bring their kids to your community for you to what? Take good care of them. And this is also lucrative. Number eight, one of my favorites, is photography. These days, even though smartphones have taken in the whole market, people have smartphones, a lot of people have smartphones, but we still need professional photographers to take our wedding pictures, because you can't mess with that. Your wedding day or party or events, you cannot get that wrong with photography. So people who are professional photographers are always in demand when it comes to wedding, anniversaries, birthdays, when it comes to even corporate photography. So you can also create a niche for yourself whereby you can even niche down to landscaping, fashion photography, wedding photography, naming ceremonies. You can do like product photography and all modeling, all those stuff. So photography is also in demand and it's easy to learn. You can learn that on YouTube, buy a camera or even rent cameras to start that business. So if you are into the media landscape and you feel like this is it, just go and start it. Number nine is gym and fitness center. People want to look good. People want to keep in shape. People want to just like get rid of one or two things, fats, like food that they've eaten, and they just get out of shape. They just need to stay fit. They need to be consistent and just to prove to themselves that they can do it. So if you have a fitness center, they will probably come to your fitness center, your gym or fitness center, to take lessons or to even keep fit. You can also do courses, online courses about fitness, and put them, or even ebooks, and sell them online. Then the 10th business idea is social media agency. Look at all the businesses I've talked about. Majority of the people who run these businesses don't have social media pages. Some of them have them, but they don't publish. So you see someone for the past 10 weeks or 2 months, they've not published anything on their social media page, because it's consuming, it's time, it's stressful, it's time consuming for them to take pictures and do these hashtags and all those stuff, and they publish that. So you can take advantage of that, create a social media agency whereby you pick their, you create social media accounts for them, create that leverage, post consistently, and you charge them, and they get to pay. There are a lot of people who are doing this, and they are making a lot of money. Then 11th bonus is, you can start also, it's laundry or dry cleaning services. Start this. People don't have the time to wash their clothes or even clean their apartments or even offices. If you have an office, you don't do that cleaning. You have to employ someone to do that. So you can start a cleaning service whereby you clean offices, apartments, estates, whatever it is, you can start. Or even laundry, whereby you wash clothes for people. So these are some of the advice, and I believe that you will get something to start from these business ideas. And may God help all of us. My name once again is Ibrahim Mustafa. You can contact me on email, on phone, for WhatsApp, consultation. And if you want trainings, I can come to your office, an organization, or country, or city to train your staff. Thank you for your time. I believe in you, and I believe in the power of your dreams. Let's go.